Morning and welcome back to the next class of theory. In the previous class we have discussed about finite state machines, its different types, and we have also discussed about the model of finite automata. We considered an example of push button and designed the finite automata for it. In this class we are going to discuss about deterministic finite automata. Deterministic finite automata is a kind of finite automata where the transition mapping is given by Q by sigma derives to Q. This means that whenever your finite automata is in a particular state Q, and in that state it gets a symbol from sigma, then based on this combination your finite automata will always make a transition to a fixed state from Q. Consider an example to design a DFA to accept all strings of length 2 over sigma, where sigma is equals to a comma b. Then the language generated will be L equals to AB, BA, AA, BB. Now, as per definition of deterministic finite automata, whenever there is a transition from a state on a particular symbol, it will always be the same transition. So, we'll make this automata by considering the initial state to be Q0, and we'll build for the first string. So whenever in Q0 I get a single input as A, then I will transit to a new state, let us call it as Q1, and from this new state whenever I get a symbol B as input, I will go to another state, and this state should be a final state because I need to accept this particular string AB. So this will be the final state, right? Now let us consider the second string BA. So again we'll start from the initial state, read B and go to a new state, let us call it as Q1 again, and then from Q1 I'll read A and then again go reach a final state. So this will accept BA. Then suppose I want to accept AA, then again I'll start from Q0, read A, go to a particular state, then from this state I'll read another A and will go to a final state. So this will accept the string AA. Now consider the last string BB. So again I will start from the initial state and then read a B, will go to Q1, then from Q1 again I will read a B and will go to QF, right? So I have generated a finite automata that will accept the strings over A and B that are of length 2. So here you can see that from Q0, whenever there is A as input, I am always going to state Q1. Whereas, whenever there is an input B from Q0, I am always going to state Q1. The same way, from Q1, whenever I get the input as A, I will go to QF. And whenever I will get the input as B, I will go to QF only. This is fixed. Therefore, this is called as a deterministic finite automata. But when I am in state QF, and I get another input as A or B, then this should not be possible to be accepted by the finite automata. Thus, we need to add a transition from QF on A and B that will take us to a state from where there should be no transition to a final state. Such states like this, and such states of the finite automata are called as dead state. So from QF, if I get A, I'll go to QD. Or if I get a B, I'll again go to QD, and from this QD, if I get any input as A or B, I will be staying in QD. So I'll never be able to reach out the final state. So the string of length greater than 2 will be rejected by the finite. This finite automata can be represented in the tuple format as follows: M equals to Q sigma delta Q0F, where Q is equals to Q0, Q1, QF, and QD. Sigma are the input symbols A and B. Delta is given by the transition diagram or transition table. Initial state Q0 is Q0 here, and final state F is nothing but QF. This can, the transition delta can be represented by the transition diagram or the transition table given as here. So in state Q0, which is the initial state, if I get A, I am going to Q1. In Q0, if I get B, I am again going to Q1. In Q1, if I get A, I'll go to QF. In Q1, if I get a B, I'll go to QF. In QF, if I get A, I'll go to QD, and in QF, if I get a B, I'll go to QD, and then in QD, whatever be the input, I will go B in QD only. Here, QF is the final state which is marked by star in the transition table. So, this was an example of deterministic finite automata. In the next class, we will discuss another example on deterministic finite automata and acceptance of string by deterministic finite automata. Thank you.